time is running out. The fire in my heart will burn me to the ground. I did my part, I tried my best. The things I'm fighting to protect always shatter into pieces in the end. Oh,
Cyril's back again for another video. This time we're finally here with the Cyril highlight videos. It's been a while since I've made one of these, but we're finally here after God knows how long, since the end of season 2, and finally we're back. Cyril season 3 on F1 2016. It's taken us a while, probably longer than expected, to actually get this set up, but we are here now. As you can see, we're in qualifying for China, because the reason for this is because I was a retard and didn't make the videos for China, for Australia and Bahrain, because I'm just, like I said, I'm a retard. And so we've actually only recruited 16 people, because we thought 22, it just caused too much lag. So we will have maybe 10 people, maybe a little bit more a race, which, like, if you go back to the F1 2015 standards, would actually be okay. Usually we've struggled with numbers anyway in the league, so having 10 people is like having 42. But as you can see, coming to the end of our lap, you would have seen at turn 1, I kind of just went straight on. It's because I have an issue with my pad where it doesn't steer right at 100%. It can go to 100% and then drop to 60. That's kind of what happened there. It's it just didn't turn, and then it went to 60, then 100. which is a bit annoying, but as you can see, we set a decent lap time for P3, but we'd end up getting dropped to P4, with Burnett F1 getting pole, Cyril Hamilton and F1 Iceman Raikkonen, and then ourselves. But we are now underway in the intermediate conditions, as Cyril Hamilton's car is just a ghost car. We've nearly steered into Iceman Raikkonen, but we go into turn one now. In a pretty good position, but we've been hit by Hydro Effects, which caused us to corner cut the corner. And I've been hit again, which has nearly caused us to spin. And then we've been hit once again by the same driver, Hydro Effects, for a third time. And we've not only lost position to him, but to surprise me. And we're losing the rear end like no tomorrow. We've had to put it down into lean to hope to control the traction. But we've now gone from third to fifth, as I think that's Iceman Raikkonen has gone for a move on Burnett F1 that's actually made him go wide, which has caused Hydra to go around the outside of him, fall around the corner, to hopefully try and get himself up into second, but I don't think it's quite worked. But we're right behind Surprise Met in P4, with Cyril Hamilton now right behind us. So this is like the top six, all separated by such a small margin. And, ooh, that's Hydra Effects who's actually made a mistake. And Surprise's gone past him, but Surprise's actually had to cut the corner, because I think he might have just missed his braking zone, or he was going to end up hitting Burnett F1. So he's actually had to drop two positions, or three positions after that now, as we've pulled over to the inside to hopefully stop Cyril Hamilton from getting past us, but he doesn't go into our slipstream, so we're just going to drift ourselves back onto the racing line. And we're now in the slipstream of Hydro Effects, who's broken quite early, so we're going past him, but yeah, he's kind of just killed us there. Just turning into us in a straight line, so I don't really know what's going on there, but we've got too eager on the power to try and keep ahead of Cyril Hamilton. We've actually lost the place. And now we got too close to him on the exit of the corner, and now Surprise Pez trying to get past us, as Iceman Raikkonen's led the way across the line. But now we've got to focus our attention on trying to get past Cyril Hamilton, season 2 championship winner, slightly undeserved. But either way, we're up his inside through turn 2 into turn 3. Can we make the move? We're trying to stick it round his outside, but we have got no traction whatsoever. We've slightly touched his rear end, but we've managed to keep going in a straight line. Can we go past him going into turn 6? We're looking at it, we're up his inside, but we've missed our braking zone. But so is Cyril Hamilton to let us past, and we've made the move, but Surprise Man has now gone up our inside to go through, and we're on, and we've been involved in another collision. This is the fifth collision in the space of 1.5 laps. It wasn't really Surprise Man's fault, but it wasn't mine either. It was mainly, it looked like it was just pure lag, because he had got past me. I tried to stick it up the inside, and then he's just lagged back into my car. The internet connection in the lobby was actually quite bad. Hydro Effects, after those few collisions, said that I was lagging like a motherfucker. So connection wasn't ideal in this session, which isn't very good at all. Now we're trying to get on the power there, which is just an absolute struggle. But we are ahead of Surprise Bear going down the main, or the back straight really. And now we cut on to lap 3, where we've caught Cyril Verstappen and FCG Oscar, who's actually gone wide, and so has Cyril Verstappen, and we've been brake checked completely by Cyril Verstappen, who didn't want to go for the move there clearly, and he's got past FCG Oscar, so we're going to have to sit behind them for a little bit longer than what we probably want, because this is losing us time hand over fist to the cars in front, and could lose us a very good position later on in the race. But we've got the slipstream of FC Josco, we've got past them both, but we can't quite get the car stopped with FC Josco on our outside. Luckily I don't think we made contact on our screen at least, but we've actually lost the position to Cyril Verstappen, but we gained one on FC Josco as we both missed the braking zone going into the hairpin of turn 14, which is never good. So now on to lap 4, we need to find a way to get past Cyril Verstappen. Need to catch him. So now onto lap 23. I didn't record any clips once again because I'm a retard, so I didn't actually show what happened between myself and Verstappen or how I'm ahead of Cyril Hamilton. But basically, the move on Verstappen was quite easy. It was just a back straight move. and we saw Cyril Hamilton. I think he mainly just messed up on strategy or something, or maybe damaged his front wing. I don't know. But myself, HydroFX, Hamilton, we all made one extra pit stop in comparison to the leaders. We weren't going to win the race anyway. We were too far behind, but we were catching HydroFX and Hamilton by about second lap. But now, as you can see, lap 24 now of 28, we're right behind HydroFX. Cyril Hamilton basically nowhere now. At this point, I think I'd already asked my engineer if Hydro had a penalty, so that just in case, so that I don't end up making a stupid move and taking myself out. But he didn't. So this is for position for the Chinese Grand Prix. This is for a podium. This would be HydroFX's, I think, second podium in Sierra, and this would be our second podium of the season. So a lot up for grabs here, and this is also for championship position as well, because if I'm correct, I was only ahead of HydroFX by 4 points at this point. So it's all to play for now for P3. So as you can clearly see, we're trying to get onto him, trying to get as close as possible. But I think now that I've mentioned championship position, I've just realised I didn't talk about it. But basically, after the first two races, Surprisement actually won, and then in race two, Cruz Davies won. As we're having a look on HydroFX, which isn't helping what I'm trying to explain. But Bernard Fong was in third at the current stage, after a third and a second, and we were fourth with a second, seventh, I believe, and whatever's going to happen here. So we're going to try and get past HydroFX down the straight, but we're going to go to his inside. Are we going to make the move? We're going to brake as hard as we can for the hairpin. Couldn't quite make it, but we've made contact with HydroFX again, twice in the same corner, and he's managed to keep in front. Somehow we've still not damaged our front wing, and I just don't understand how. But we are still going strong, as we're now looking on the inside of HydroFX going into turn one. We're going to move over to try and get a wider line, but HydroFX has held it around our outside, but we've got the inside line now going through turn two. And are we going to make it stick? We're going to try and hang it around his outside now for turn three. Side by side still, trying to get the power as early as we can around turn three and turn four. And now into turn five, we're losing the rear end, pretty much a flat out corner. And HydroFX has just turned across us at turn six, which has just not helped us at all. So that is another opportunity that we've wasted on trying to get past HydroFX, which is not good, because we need to make a move very quickly. Just to help our race, really. We weren't going to win, but there's no point wasting about knowing that you're faster than the car ahead and just deciding to overtake on the last lap, because you never know what could happen. So we need to get past him as early as possible. But at this point, I was toying with him. As you can see, we've locked up all four wheels, I think, at that stage. And we nearly crashed into the back of HydroFX. And that was just too close for comfort there. And my heart was in my mouth at that point. I was so scared that I was about to hit him, and then we'd end up both losing a chance for the podium. But now, going down the straight, all we can do is just try and keep up with him. Going to have a cheeky weave to the right-hand side, hopefully just to put him off, but it clearly hasn't fazed him. Now going into the final corner. Bennett found a nice man, Raikkonen, who were 1-2 at the stage, are already through Sector 1. And myself and Hydra are only going through, only starting the next lap, which is lap 27 of 28. So we need to get a move on now. Need to make a move very, very soon at this stage. And we're all over the back of HydroFX now through turn 2 into turn 3. No overtaking at the moment. There's nowhere to actually overtake here. Into turn 4. It's all about trying to get the power as early as possible. And then going through the flat out turn 5. And then through turn 6. Now all over the back of HydroFX. Where can we make a move? I think the main place would be down the back straight, but we want to get past him as early as possible. But obviously the safest place would be down the back straight. We've actually got a very good run on him going into the right-hander, and we aren't going to make the move stick. As Hydra shuts the door, and or we just weren't committed to a move like that. There's no point going for an unnecessary risk like that. So we're going to have to stay behind him for a few more corners, hopefully. And now going into the left-hander, and then onto the right. This is probably our big chance now to get past him. Got to get on the power as early as possible. Hydra effects. We've had a better run out the corner than him. I think he might have had better traction. But we're now in the slipstream, the OP slipstream. We're going to shoot past him, hopefully. Catching. We're now looking on his inside. We've made the move. But can we make it stick? Hydrofex is broken very late, but due to us being on the inside, we had... and we would stay in P3 through the last corner now. Cheeky corner cut just to finish it off. And now we can hopefully just pull away from Hydrofex and get this P3, which would happen, as you'll see now. Burnout F1 ended up winning the race ahead of Iceman Raikkonen. We will come home in P3, which is a pretty good position, I guess. It could have been worse, but at the same time, it could have been better if it wasn't for the collisions that we had with Hydrofex and Freismet. But we're going to come across the line, not corner cutting the final corner. Bit of a midget weave, really. It's not really a weave, it's mainly going over to the left and then the right. But as you can see, Bennett F1 won the race, with Iceman Raikkonen dropping off 4.2 seconds behind. Well, we were 38 seconds behind, with Hamilton beating Hydra, Freismet in 6th, Cruz Davis in 7th. But that is the chapter standings now. I know it says Season 2, but trust me, this is Season 3. I just cocked up. But yeah, guys, that is basically it from me today. I do hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button. And I'll hopefully get the AOR video out soon. But either way, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.
Walk, little walk, small talk, big thoughts, gonna tell them all just what I want. That street, two streets, I see you and me hanging on the empty swings. Count high, low, don't worry, my eyes are closed, I'm the Superman and it's my show. One shoe, two, gonna kick with my new shoes, I'm gonna kick until I need new shoes.
Hi, those hipsters, I'm gonna dance.
I said it, don't stop. Don't stop talking to me. It's not-